الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you believe, fear Allah as he should be feared and die not except on the state of Islam. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great favor to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah, Surah At-Tawbah, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, addressing the believers in a tone of reproaching and blaming, saying, يا أيها الذين آمنوا ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله اثاقلتم إلى الأرض أرضيتم بالحياة الدنيا من الآخرة فما متاع الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة إلا قليل. Or you believe, what is the matter with you when is you being called to march forward in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you've been heavily inclined or cling heavily to the earth. Are you contented and pleased with the life of this world and turning away from the akhirah? Don't you know that the world of this life or the life of this world, it's only small and insignificant commodity compared to the life of the akhirah. This ayah was revealed in concerning the expedition of Tabuk. So in the expedition of Tabuk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam calling the companion ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, the whole society of Medina, those who are able and they have the ability and they have the ahliyah, those who are in charge of that, to really march forth the expedition. Some of them, they've been really cling heavily, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thaqala ila al-ard. And in this ayah, there's many lessons. And one of the lessons that we would like to share with you today is the fiqh of al-maslaha. The fiqh of al-maslaha is the understanding is what is beneficial for you, what is good for you. Now, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to determine in our life your priority. To put things, your action, that you know by order of predecessors. So the order of priority, say what most important action that we have. So for example, if you have like different tasks that you're going to do, you're going to put priority. This one is the most, you know, important, and you put them into an order of priority. So in your life, what is the order of priority that you have to put for the action when you are traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala define for the believer what is the highest priority, because this is Amrun Jama. This is something that concerns the whole society, the whole community. Yeah? Now, when you define your priority, then you will define based on the priority what are the most beneficial thing for you. By defining the most beneficial, what we call maslaha, you also evaluate somehow what are the harmful things. Therefore, the harmful thing will be those things that comes to be an obstacle in fulfilling this beneficial thing to you. This gain, this thing that you're going to lead you to objecting or achieving your objective. So you see from this ayah, so if you try to implement what I have said for this ayah, what is the greatest priority, what is the greatest maslaha, where is success, is to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, following him and supporting him and be with him in the expedition of Tabuk. What will be the mafsada, what will be the evil thing, what will be the thing that someone is causing his harm to himself or to herself, is to stay away, to stay behind, to heavily be inclined to the earth. So that's the big mafsada. So the mafsada is what lead you, one, to the wrath of Allah, and the maslaha, what is going to help you to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to His rahm. So this is very clear. And that's why, ikhwani, the whole sharia, the whole Islamic jurisprudence and the whole sharia, the whole spirit of the sharia is based on these two items. Jalbul maslaha wa dar'ul mafsada. You gain, you try to do all it, you put all your effort to get the benefit thing, to achieve or to gain things that help you, that is going to help your condition of life, help your human condition, help your subhanAllah, your situation, and all of that to help you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a serenity, in a stability, in tranquility, in peace, and so on. So this is the maslaha. The mafsada, however, is the one that is going to be obstructing, the one that's going to be obstacle, the one that is going to be deviated from the true maslaha. Now, the big problem here is to define this maslaha, to define what is the beneficial thing for you. So, the scholar, rahimahumullah ta'ala, by studying the book of Allah and this, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they extracted from us the base of the maslaha and the mafsada. The base, so what is maslaha? So I'm going to keep during the khutbah say maslaha. The maslaha is what is beneficial for you. What is mafsada? Is the evil thing to you, or the thing that is going to corrupt you, the thing that is evil. So this is the maslaha, the good thing. The mafsada is the bad thing. And the whole sharia is based on these two things, to gain the maslaha and to be prohibited and push away from you the mafsada. So when we dig into the text of the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us, the scholar, they defined five categories, main category that we call necessities. These necessities is upon the believers as individual, as a community, to safeguard. And by safeguarding them, you will help yourself and the community to achieve a level of stability, of peace, of justice, and of cohesion into the society. These five things are, and we are obligated to safeguard. So the maslaha here is to safeguard them. The mafsada is to have shortcoming, or to ignore them, or to corrupt them. So the first one is your faith, is the deen. The second one is the life. The third one is the lineage. The fourth one is the intellect. And the fifth one, which is the wealth of the properties. So when someone, for example, he feels safe, you know, on his life, safe on his intellect, safe he has the freedom and the safety and the stability and the peace to fulfill his ibadah, his worship, safe into his family and safe into his property. That's how you help a society to grow together into stability, peace and justice and so on. And this is, subhanAllah, are what we call, the scholar, they call it, the scholar of the usul, they call it al-daruriyat. However, so you see, the base of the maslaha and the mafsada defined through these five category that upon us is to safeguard. And you find the sharia, subhanAllah, very meticulous in this. When it comes to the life, whoever who kills a soul is a really great and big major sin. And whoever who protects the soul is like protecting the whole humankind. The same thing for the property, whoever steal, that's a dhulm, is a big, great and big major sin. And so on, whoever who protect and give the amana is one of the greatest, you know, action of good, and so on. The progeny and the lineage is to protect it by protecting, building the family, to be nice into the family, to be kind, fulfill your duty, having the peace into the family between the spouses, having the right education. What will conflict such peace and stability is al-fawahish, like the zina, and so on, from what we see in the society of today. So that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them a major, you know, sins. So here how we define our maslaha. So if someone, for example, telling you, I'm seeking your maslaha, said, you seeking my maslaha in which context? How do you define maslaha? Because Allah defined for me what is maslaha, and that's what we need to know. So when you look at this, it said, okay, so I need to protect my life, I need to protect my deen, I need to protect my progeny, my family, to protect my, you know, my wealth, my property, which is that I seek them in the way of the halal. But is this enough? No, it's not enough. Why? Because all this masalah, they all come to be united and to be kind of, they arose from one center maslaha, one center maslaha. What is the center maslaha? What is the center thing that we seek? And when you seek it, therefore you put goodness and barakah, and you have everything else on the right path. This one is seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every maslaha, if it does not have in its essence and in its objective the pleasure of Allah, therefore this maslaha, it's not a maslaha. You're telling me I'm protecting my life. Say, how do you protect your life? For what sake you protecting your life? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants you to live a life of dignity. A life of someone who has, subhanAllah, servant to Allah, not servant to the dunya. Have humility to Allah, not humiliated by people and follower of other system. No. So you see here, the heart, the core of all the masalah that we have mentioned has one item, one aspect. It's your direction, your truthful direction to Allah. That's the maslaha. Why? So for example, say everyone is seeking the pleasure of Allah. Say, do not limit the understanding of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gain the reward from Allah, to be embraced by the rahmah of Allah, and so on. Open up and widen your understanding. You know what it means to seek the pleasure of Allah beside what we have mentioned. To establish justice in the universe. There is no way for the justice to be established in the universe if it's your way not seeking the pleasure of Allah. Because in seeking the pleasure of Allah, that's how you're going to fulfill the truth and be following the right path, and you're going to negate and refute the falsehood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach you when you're seeking His ridwan, not seeking the ridwan in absolute pleasure. Not seeking, like subhanAllah, is intellectual pleasure. The pleasure is in acting and in acting good. If you do something bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to be pleased with you. Therefore, the pleasure of Allah, you're going, you are traveling, you are walking toward the pleasure of Allah, that is the greatest maslaha. Therefore, everything, the life, the lineage, the intellect, the property, your possession, everything need to be within this system. Within the system of seeking the pleasure of Allah. That's why the ayah that we have started with define this. All you who believe, what happened to you, what is the matter to you or with you, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, infiru, march, walk, flee to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So fleeing and marching toward the way of Allah is your qibla. When you stand in the salah, you're not going to choose any qibla. Allah defined for you the qibla. Therefore, when you turn into your life, what is your qibla? When you wake up in the morning, what is your qibla? What is your orientation? Where are you going? Where are you traveling? You say, I'm traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it into different layers, not just in the prayer. Make it in the way of your planning. Make it in your values. Make it into your moral, make it into your akhlaq, make it into your goal. That's the meaning of having qibla to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And based on this, all what we have mentioned from these five main categories that really summarize the most of the maslaha and corrupting it or go against it, define the mafsada, the evil thing. If it's not regarded through a truthful path that you get into it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be the full corruption, the complete corruption. I'll give you example, ikhwani. For example, say for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this life. So you want to live a life of dignity. You want to live a life of someone subhanallah who has importance. Importance not with the dunya things. Importance regarded, respected. A servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You only can achieve it if you make your path Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you make your marching. So what the meaning of that? Whatever, as we have mentioned in the last khutbah, whenever thing that you're going to do, you will bring your relation between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is Allah is going to put barakah in it? How many of us, mashallah, they do istikhara. But why we only do istikhara for the thing that we want for us? You see, so if you make that istikhara, the type of the istikhara, the type of the dua, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give it to you if it's had good, right? So make it in your planning. Make it in your activity. Make you in your activism. You know, make it into your contribution to the society. You have to include that. If not, you're going to be deviated from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when you regard these necessities in the way of Allah, and they are regarded as maslaha, if you do defend them, and someone subhanallah, he might die defending his life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to accept you as a shaheed. If you have your property, that is your halal, and someone subhanAllah want to take it away from you, and you fight with this person, and that person might kill the person who's defending his property, he dies a shaheed. If someone defending his family, and he died, he's got killed, he dies as a shaheed. If someone subhanAllah, and this is hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever is killed defending his property, he's a shaheed. من قتل دون دمه فهو شهيد. Whoever who killed defending his life, he's a shaheed. من قتل دون أهله فهو شهيد. Whoever killed defending his family, he's a shaheed. من قتل دون سبحان الله أولا دون دينه defending his faith فهو شهيد. However, the shahada not for any life that we live. The shahada not for any family that we have. That's the key here. Because if you do not have the foundation, everything that you oriented, the qibla of it is Allah, then the qibla is other than Allah. If it's other than Allah, then this life does not have any meaning. For example, you find people, they will say, we want to secure peace and we want to secure safety for the community, for example. Say, how are you going to secure this safety? How? Is there in what you are doing this element of truthful, being truthful in your path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Maybe by trying to bring safety to the Muslim, you are losing all your moral, you are losing all your akhlaq, you are adhering to another system who obliges you to accept things that he prohibited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are you going to say to your children? Say, no, this is, it's okay because we are Muslim, we need to have a presence. I said, how can I have a presence in a society that they fight Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There's different way of presence. You have to define your presence into the society. Not they define for you how to be present, and then you seek the way how they defined it, and in seeking that, you will be deviated from the path of Allah and losing all your principle, all your values. That's something, subhanAllah, it's a big question mark that we see in it now today into our society. You see, for example, Muslim adhering to totally different. For example, someone, if he get into organization, activism or institution or like politics, one of the conditions is to adhere to their principles. Maybe in their principle, they have people they fighting to legalize what Allah made haram. How can you adhere to such a principle and you're saying, I'm doing for the sake of the Muslim? Now, I tell you, is this maslaha? Come back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قال, go forth, march in the sake of Allah, which is, subhanAllah, which is condition, which is way. You cannot water down your akhlaq because of the sake of the Muslim. None of the Muslim is going to help you. Say, yeah, Allah, I did it for the sake of the Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell you, I didn't tell you to do it. I ask you to find integrity within yourself. I ask you to be right. I ask you to be righteous. I didn't ask you to water down your values for the sake of others that maybe they do not know even that you are talking on their behalf because you didn't ask them, can I talk on your behalf? When it comes to the life, living a life with no dignity does not have any value in the sight of Allah. Living a life of evil does not have any value in the sight of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'll give you an example, a striking example in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. the people of Musa, some of the people of Musa, they worship the calf, as you know. طيب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to grant them the ability to repent. How was, subhanAllah, what was the way of their repentance? Is to kill them. You're going to be shocked. But if you try to analyze it, this is Musa alayhi salam. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِي يَا قَوْمِي إِنَّكُمْ قَدْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ بِاتِّخَاذِكُمْ الْعِجْلِ. You'll be unjust to yourself by taking other than Allah, by taking this calf as a god. لَقَدْ ظَلَمْتُمْ فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ. Go forth back repentantly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? فَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Kill those who did it. So the one who's going to be killed, he might say, no, I don't adhere to this. I'm going to run away. But he accepted it. Why? Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you read carefully this ayah, قَالَ فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ. Tubu to your bari. Al-bari'u, he the creator, but creator, not khalq. Al-bari'u, he's the one who gave you this, fashioned you. Al-bari'u, he's the one who gave you life. Therefore, the life is a gift from Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like telling them, I give you life to dignify this life, to honor this life. But this life, you used it for something very evil. Now, if Allah wants you, for Allah to forgive you, Allah asks you to give me back my life. Give me back my life. Then I will honor you in the day of judgment. Show me your commitment that you truly want to repent. So you see, Ikhwani, not any life is regarded, only the life that is being honored by the way of Allah. قَالَ اقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. That's why people who seeking to secure themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ فَتَرَى الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرْضًا. You see those who have disease in their heart, they trying, seeking from everywhere to find a way to protect themselves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what are you doing? Is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enough for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who saved Ibrahim against a whole society that they built for him, a whole structure of fire. He said, حَسْبِي اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you in the Quran to help you eradicate, take away that fear from your heart, to not water down your values. And this is when it comes to the maslaha of the life. When it comes to the children, when it comes to the children of the people around you, for the children of our community, for our spouses, the men for the wives and the wives for the men and so on. If we don't take care of each other, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, how can we regard them? We regard them within this path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That becomes a maslaha. That becomes honoring. So you cannot be honoring your child by giving him things that is going to lead him away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Alhamdulillah, I'm honoring my children. He said, not, you're not honoring. This is not maslaha. And this is the big problem that most of our people are doing. They are defending or working on the names without the content. So we're talking, I have to defend my life. But what life? I have to defend my children. But what, you know, your children, what you have to defend into your children. I have to protect my family. What to protect in them? Protect what? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the Quran, قَالَ يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ. From among your spouses and your children are enemy to you. Can you imagine? Say, subhanAllah, you enter and you see your family. These are my enemy. Can you imagine? This is Allah telling you. Why? Because if your family... It's like a woman or a man, they look at their family and all of them, they taking them, dragging them to other than the way of Allah. Look at the story in people of the story of the cave. It's not that Al-Khidr killed a young boy. Why? Because that young boy was, if he lived, he's going to lead astray his parents. For it was Allah's gift to take that boy from an early age. So subhanAllah, it becomes your own child, your own father, your own mother, your own husband, your own wife can be an enemy to you. So this is not maslaha. So I said, I want to protect my family. What do you want you to do? They asking for that. But if they asking for that, you become enemy to them if you help them on what they ask you when it is taking them from the way of Allah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not be deluded. Do not like the way how these people, they have children and wealth and possession. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using that to punish them in this dunya. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Tawbah about the hypocrite to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَا تُعْجِبْكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَعَذِّبَهُمْ بِهَا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَتَزَقَ أَنفُسُهُمْ وَهُمْ كَافِرُونَ. And Nuh alayhi salam, go read Surah Nuh. In the end, what Nuh said? He said, Ya Allah, they disobeyed me and they followed those who their possession, their wealth, and their children add them only corruption. He said, Subhanallah, قالوا وقال نوح ربي إنهم عصوني واتبعوا من لم يزده ماله وولده إلا خسار. So the children and the wealth are, Subhanallah, is like Subhanallah, it has two sides. A side that is going to take you to paradise and a side that is going to help you to make you to fall into hellfire. So that's when we say the maslaha, the thing that is good, I'm going to protect my children, I'm going to protect my relation, I'm going to work on the safety on our community, said, put a question mark. How are you going to do it? And in which way? Is this the way is going to preserve your value? Is going to preserve your akhlaq? Is going to preserve your march to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or is going to have you deviated fully and away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is going to lead us to have the next generation, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُ الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيْهِ. The generation that came after them, the generation that they lost the prayer, they follow their whims, and they're going to be, وَالْعِيَذُ بِلَذَرْ about to hellfire. If we do not think about these things seriously, that's how we're preparing for the next generation. Ya Allah, that's what we are preparing for the next generation. If a young sister comes to complain, say, look, are these Muslims, how they doing, and coming out in picture with people who really conflict with our morality, how can you do, subhanAllah? Young sister, she has, subhanAllah, more intellect and thinking and heard to see such a thing. And people said, no, we have to have our voice. What voice? Well, ask a question. Where are we going? Look at your next generation. How are they going to be? Khwani, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who fulfilled His promise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَصْدُقُكَ إِذَا صَدَقْتَ. The protection of life, the protection of children, the protection of all what we have mentioned, all what you want as a way to lead you to your success. It has, subhanAllah, to come from within, from your sidq, your truthfulness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us a very beautiful ayah in the Quran, in Surah Al-Fath, لَقَدْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ رَسُولَهُ الرُّؤْيَا بِالْحَقِّ. Allah fulfilled the promise to His Prophet, the vision that He saw, that they're going to enter Mecca, Amini, safe. قَالَ مُحَلِّقِينَ رُؤُوسَهُمْ. And they have shaved, which is mean they fulfilled their worship in full safety and peace. لَا يَخَافُونَ لَا تَخَافُونَ. You're not going to be scared. So Allah guarantee for them peace, quietness, tranquility, in the present when they're going to be, and in the future, قَالَ لَا تَخَافُونَ. So you ask yourself, this is the maslaha that I want. This is what I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fulfill what He has promised me. But you have to fulfill the condition for Allah to fulfill that. Where can we find that? If you read the ayah before this one, you find the answer. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال الذين كفروا جعلوا في قلوبهم حمية حمية الجاهلية قال فأنزل الله سكينته على رسوله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down tranquility on His messenger and on the believer وألزمهم كلمة التقوى. Listen, dear brother, respected sister, and make them to be adhering completely to the word of piety, which is لا إله إلا الله. وَكَانُوا أَحَقَّ بِهَا. And they were those who deserve it. وَأَهْلَهَا. And the people of لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So, ikhwani, it's very clear, it's very easy. We want that Allah to be with us. We want first to march toward our success. Then make your qibla Allah. As you make your qibla Allah to Mecca in your salat, make your qibla Allah in every action. into your life, into your family, into your possession, into your activism, into your activity, into your task that you want to fulfill, into the good that you want to share with the society. Do it with tawajjuhun sadiqun ila Allah, a truthful, sincere orientation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you do that? To be someone who deserves la ilaha illallah. To be one of the people of la ilaha illallah. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Al-Fatih. To be deserving la ilaha illallah. And to be deserving la ilaha illallah, to regard la ilaha in your action. How can you regard la ilaha illallah with your children? Is to concentrate on make them subhanallah righteous, not rich into the in the future. How can you make your parents to be regard them with la ilaha illallah? Is to obey them, not to look at them as source of money or source of security as long as you are young. How can you regard la ilaha illallah within with your spouses? Is to help each other. How can you regard la ilaha illallah into your community? Is to bring them the safety in the way of Allah. Because when we are scared, when we have fear, subhanallah, we completely misunderstand what is the beneficial for us. For example, there's many people who work very hard, for example, to fight against the Islamophobia. But he said, okay, it's good to do it, but are we going to do it by losing your own morality? You cannot do that. What do you call the way or what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was facing in Mecca? It was an Islamophobia, right? Abu Jahl was the leader of Islamophobia. They stopped the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam even to pray. They cannot even have a meeting. How the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam counter that? How he faced all that? By regarding la ilaha illallah. By having the values of la ilaha illallah. By having the objective of la ilaha illallah. So do not water down our la ilaha illallah. Do not water down our value and we call it is beneficial for the Muslim. Say no, it's not beneficial for the Muslim. What is beneficial for the Muslim is when they are on the path of seeking ridwanullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us fulfill that. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Dear brother, respected sister, this subject is it's very wide, vast, controversial subject, but it's not really controversy when it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when someone said this is beneficial for us, he said, hold on, I know what is beneficial for me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, march toward Allah. If this is going to help me get closer to Allah, if this is going to help me be truthful to all the aspects of my deen, if this is going to safeguard my dignified life, if this is going to safeguard my akhlaq, if this is going to safeguard my path to achievement of justice that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defined in his book and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam strove all his life for it. Therefore, to be the people of la ilaha illallah, I will suggest three things. Very simple. The first thing, the beneficial thing that you seek and that you work for to get, make it to be something certain. Because many people say this is beneficial for the Muslim. He said, but he's not certain. Do you have a proof? Show me evidence. Show me, I'll go with you. Show me. He said, no, no, this is because in the Sharia. I said, don't talk about the Sharia. I want things that is beneficial. Someone he say, I'm thirsty. He said, there's a place, there's water. Truly, I have to trust you. I have to see, you know, this is the picture, this is the map. There is a source of water. Okay, I'll go with you. So this is maslaha yaqiniya. The second thing, which is the most important, have consciousness of ourselves. Do not have people to define who you are. Especially for the youth. Do not have people to define you, therefore you're going to follow, every day you're going to follow other people. This is, you know, the vegan thing is going right, but it's not like with Islam, but it looks good. It does not look good. It's far. The equality of gender, wallahi, this is, that's not. Come back to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be careful. So you say, who am I? When you define yourself, when you are conscious of yourself, then you define your relation between you and Allah. You came from Allah and you're traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tomorrow you're going to be in the grave. All the thing that is being done around you, wallahi, will not benefit you if you do not ask yourself who you are and what is your relation between you and Allah. And the third one comes is to repent to Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Maryam, then who came precede them or came after them a generation that they lost the prayer. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us have our generation to not lose the prayer. وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ May Allah help us to not have our generation follow their whims and follow, forget the book of Allah. قَالَ إِلَّا except, and we want to be from those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put as exception. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَآمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا صَالِحًا They repent to Allah. They believe in the concept that we have, you know, trying to communicate and convey to you. And قَالَ وَعَمِلُوا صَالِحًا And do action, good action. And this action based on the priority with the foundation that you put on all your beneficial that you're seeking. It's your truthful walking, marching to Allah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين اللهم تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم ارزقنا التوبة يا كريم اللهم ارزقنا التوبة يا كريم اللهم اجعلنا عليك متوكلين اللهم اجعلنا بك نخاصم وإليك نحاكم وبك نؤمن وإليك نستسلم يا رب العزة يا أرحم الراحمين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وآخر